always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Diamond Zone Monday morning edition. Happy Christmas week, Hanukkah. It's going to be a great week, guys, and I hope everybody's getting ready for the holidays. Whatever your religious beliefs are, I just hope everybody has a very safe and happy rest of the year. It's going to be phenomenal. And just so you guys know, the schedule, we will be Diamond Zone business as usual this week, Monday through Friday. The opportunity presentations will be business as usual. You guys know the schedule there. Tonight at 6 o'clock, I'll touch on that in a second. But so the only 2 days that will be disrupted will be Sunday, Christmas Eve, and Monday, Christmas Day. So no schedule Sunday, no opportunity call. Monday morning, there'll be no Diamond Zone Christmas Day or no Monday night opportunity call. So those will be the only two things that will be disturbed through these holidays. We won't disturb anything for New Year's because New Year's is New Year's, so whatever. In fact, New Year's, we got to put the pedal to the metal, right? You don't take the pedal off the metal during New Year's. Now it's time to go to work. So what I want to talk about today, guys, is we're going to talk a little bit about, you know, really honing in your skills as you go out there and start talking to people. So before I get into that, let me go to my screen share. And I got to figure out what I want to share. I want to share this first and foremost. Okay, hopefully you could see that. Can you see that, Dick and Mary? Okay, so this is on my Facebook page, guys. This is promoting tonight's call. So, okay, I tell everybody to do this. I want to see people do it. See this share button? Click it. Click it. Click it. And share it with as many people as you can. Okay, you know what you're doing when you do that? And I'm not saying you're going to build your business this way, but if you at least share it with somebody, you're fishing, right? At least you're fishing. At least somebody got it. Maybe somebody will say, hey, what's that? Oh, yeah, that's that two-minute video Dick sent me. Yeah, you know what? My boss is pissing me off this week. I'm going to get on that call. Okay, who knows? You don't know. Okay, so my point is there should be, you know, we average about 120 participants on this call. Okay, I would love to see over 100 shares. Wonder how many people would be on that particular call. So my question is this: if we can't share a post, how can we say we're trying to build a business? And I'm, like I said, I'm not saying it's the magic answer by any stretch. Okay, I'm going to share with you today what we need to do. Okay, but obviously that's a very, very necessary first step. Okay, so having said that, okay, there's all the smiling faces. Everybody wave. Before I put you on screen, look at, oh, Diamond Zoners. Aren't they pretty? Pretty diamonds. Look at Christy's hair. It looks so pretty today. Christy, your hair is so nice. I don't know. Lloyd, you got to do something with your hair. That's why I wear a hat, brother. All right. Let's do this. All right. Was there anything else I had to put on here? Oh, yeah. Today at 10. Everybody knows today at 10 o'clock, right? You have the world update call, okay? And here's one thing I also want to talk about. You know, everybody here has an upline, Okay. And I always tell people, I had a call the other day from somebody, and I always leave the person anonymous because, you know, people sometimes share with me certain things that they're going through and they're not my organization. And this person had said to me, they said, "Hey, Jeff, listen, I want to go fast. This is a good conversation. I want to go fast, but you know, the person that brought me in the business isn't going as fast as I want to go. And the person above that person is really kind of an incubator. And I've been on your call every morning and I feel part of your team." And I said, "That's the purpose of Diamond Zone. No matter whose line you're in, we don't care on Diamond Zone. Okay, I think anybody who wants to take this journey, okay, I want to provide a platform. Whatever you guys do with it, you do with it. But I said to this person, listen, no matter what you do, you got to build your business. You got to be the leader for your upline. If you don't have an upline, be the leader. I give you permission. I've anointed you as the leader to go fast." This person is using their upline as an excuse on why they can't go fast. I go, "Wait a minute, what? Am I missing something here?" "Okay, wait a minute. Okay, I think I'm good, right? Am I good? Mary, can you hear me?" "Okay." I said, "Am I missing something?" I said, "Now, you always show respect to your upline, always. You know when you put your upline down, you're putting down, right, your organization, you're putting down multi-level, and that cuts two ways. You're also putting down the industry. Okay, if you talk bad about another company, okay, you're putting down, right, it's like being in the NFL and saying, I hate that team. I hate that ownership. You're putting down your livelihood. You never do that. And here's the other thing. You never compete with your upline. Okay, you never compete with your upline. Okay, if Jeremy Roma had a meeting, if Jeremy Roma had a meeting, I'm just using this as an example, because you guys know, right, Lisa and I are self-sufficient, and Jeremy wants leadership. He wants us to be leaders, and he loves the fact that we do Diamond Zone every morning. But if Jeremy Roma decided to do a meeting, okay, on a Wednesday at 7 a.m., guess what? Diamond Zone would be redirected to his meeting. That's my respect for Jeremy. I would never compete with my upline. Why? Because especially if I have a plugged-in upline, that would be like me saying, okay, you know what? Monday morning, okay, we're moving Diamond Zone to 10 o'clock. Because you know what? Even though Chad and Natita are doing the corporate update call, I don't really care about that. Diamond Zone's at 10. Guys, that's not correct. That's wrong in my opinion. So I just want people to know, take ownership of your business, but show respect, right? And let the right ears hear this, the message, okay? Show respect for the people, okay, that are supporting your team. Okay, and if you have somebody in your organization, if you have an upline that's not as plugged in as you, then be the leader. Real simple. You don't need a diploma, but if you want a diploma, I'm going to give it to you today. Here's your diploma to be a leader. And I would say that if your upline was on the call, your upline wants you to be a leader. So don't let your upline slow you down, guys. Okay, Lisa and I always went faster than our uplines, always. But when they called, I showed respect. Okay, I listened. Okay, and I still had to play my ball. And that's the key. And I'm just telling you, this is how you stay in the industry 25 years. Okay, you got to understand that there's rules to the game. Okay, and you just can't be out there, right, and just doing your own thing and showing no respect for the operation that you're involved with. Okay, enough about that. All right, that was just on my head because of this call I had with this particular person. And you know what was so great about this call? They were so relieved because this is pretty much a person brand new in the industry. She goes, "I didn't know I could go faster than my upline." I didn't know. I thought if they went slow, I had to go slow. But Jeff, I'm so frustrated. I want to go fast. I said, go fast. Don't worry. Okay. So guys, understand that message. So here's what we want to do. Okay, you guys, a lot of you have seen this training before. A lot of the trainings we repeat because there's only so much to tell you all, right? But I like to break down different aspects of a training. Because you could take one training and you could spin it 50 different ways, all right? In our business, okay, understand something. None of us here have employees. None of us have an infrastructure cost, right? And everybody says, well, we don't have traditional overhead. Do you know the only overhead you have is what you invest in yourself? That's a pretty good overhead, right? It's a narcissistic overhead, right? It's whatever you want to put into yourself. So how do we invest in ourselves? Well, you invest in your product, right? You might be on loyalty. You may be investing in a trip to Los Angeles, which I recommend everybody getting to, right? Or maybe personal development tapes. Or maybe you say, you know what, I want more, and you go to a Tony Robbins seminar. Everything you do is to better yourself. Because as you know, when you feel good, you do good, right? When you have confidence, they were talking about this yesterday. I'm a big sports guy. And a lot of you, this may go over some of your heads, but maybe you'll get the analogy. A lot of you know that the Los Angeles Rams, a professional football team, okay, last year they were the laughingstock of the NFL. This year they hired a brand new coach, 31 years old, youngest coach in NFL history, 31 years old. They completely turned around their season. Okay, completely. They are now 10-4. Okay, 10 wins. Last year they had, I think, 3 wins the whole year. Okay, so they're going to the playoffs. And they interviewed the coach. And as they kept winning games, guess what started to happen? Okay, they took an attitude of hoping they're going to win to now expecting to win. Completely different mindset. Now they're going to go, oh my God, I hope I can get the playoff. Now they're thinking, we're going to win every single game. See, this is what confidence does. And this is what I want to instill in all of you. Once you get the confidence, here's the saying. Once you know that you know, and everybody else knows that you know, it's over. When you know that you know that you know, and nobody can tell you differently that what you know is not what is right, you're wealthy. When you believe without a doubt, you know that you know. Okay? And so when you have that confidence, now how do you get that confidence? How do you get it? It's by taking the journey. It's by taking the journey, whatever your journey is. But I will tell you, it's the most rewarding journey you will ever take. World Global Network, the industry itself is unbelievable. It really is. And I always tell people, you guys have heard me say this. Once you get a taste of this, you can't do anything else. It's almost a curse. It really is. Okay. Where else would I go right now? Where else would I go? Right. If I have a $500,000 a year lifestyle, where else would I go to get that opportunity? Think, where am I going? Are you kidding? I'm going to go to Craigslist and go, let's look for that $500,000 a year job. Okay, really? Okay, so you're a serial entrepreneur. And I'm telling you guys, it's a curse. But it's the best curse. Maybe curse is the wrong word. Okay, when you understand that you could be paid what you're worth, man, now you treat your business differently. But how do you create desire in what you got? You got to know the working rules. And the working rules is this. This is what we do. Since you don't have a storefront, right? Since you don't have advertising costs, since you're not running radio ads or television ads, how are you bringing people into your store? Because you guys know you all have a store, right? Your store is World Global Network. World Global Network decides what products they're going to put on the shelf, right? And you all know what's been going on with our products, okay? And now we're adding different types of products. In 2018, we're going to have more products on our shelf. Our job is to advertise to people what we have on our store shelf. And most of us are doing that how? Through the internet, right? Most of us are doing it with our personal contacts. So we're advertising every day. You got to have the traditional mentality, because unless a product is moved, you don't earn money. You only earn money when a product is sold. And when you sell a product, you make a commission. And when you have a team of people selling the product, you make a percentage off the team, right? So we get paid on movement of product. So we got to teach everybody how to advertise what we got. Now, here's the only difference. We have two things to offer. There's two things we're offering to our people. We're offering great product, right? But the allure of the product gives them an opportunity to also want to own the business. So we're offering not only the hamburgers, we're offering the franchise, right? Now, you can't call this a franchise. You know that? This is not a franchise. If you want to call it, it's people franchising. So I'm giving people an opportunity to change their financial situation surrounding a new category creator product. You guys know the spiel, right? You guys know it. You hear it every time if you're on a presentation. So now what we have to do is advertise what we have, but we got to get people's attention. You know how you get people's attention? Okay, you got to get people's attention with the right message. We're going to talk a little bit about that today. You got to attract them, and you got to have the right approach. So the way you create desire within people is by advertising, getting their attention, right? Attracting them and having the right approach. So let's break that down. Let's start with advertising. Okay? What are you advertising? Well, first of all, if you don't have the product, it's really hard to talk about your product if you don't have one on your wrist. Okay? Get familiar with your product, right? Get familiar with it. Okay? You don't have to become a product expert, but you should become a product of the product always, right? That when we were in supplements, we used every product every day. We had 35 products. I had a baggie full of pills, a baggie. And one of the ways I would market it, right, is when I went to lunch, Lisa would baggie up all my pills. And she'd say, listen, just do one thing for me. When you're meeting with all these other executives, as you're building these health clubs all around the country, because that's what we did, she said, just do me a favor. When you're at lunch, just take the bag and put it on your plate. Just take the bag and empty all 35 pills on your plate. Because I did. I took all the product. And so I started doing that. And you know what people started to say? What's that? What are you doing? And I would just start going like this. I go, that's my wife's business. What do you mean your wife's business? Yeah, my wife started her own company, supplements. Okay, this one is for my prostate. This one's for energy. This one's for this. This one's for that. And guess what happened? Conversation. So I was advertising my product. Every time I go in the sauna or I'm around people, you know what I do? Here's what I do. Watch what I do. I go like this. Just like this. And people go, what are you doing? I go, well, this is my product. I'm doing an EKG. Conversation. It's taking advantage of when you're around people, are you taking advantage of every opportunity to go fishing? Well, that's pretty cool. What does it do? An EKG? Who knows where it goes? It doesn't matter. You're fishing. So you always want to become a product of the product. Take advantage of every opportunity to show the product an opportunity. So when we say start with your family and friends, okay, it's because it's easier to talk to. They're much easier to talk to when you do this. Okay? Now, watch what happens. When you talk to people that you know, first of all, it gets you moving quicker, right? Because, you know what, how can I not talk to my mom? Doesn't mean your mom's going to do it. But I want you guys to get good at practicing. When you practice, you know what happens? You know the purpose of practice? Do you understand what the purpose of practice is in anything you will ever do in your life? To build your confidence. If you're going to make a mistake, let's make a mistake with somebody. Let's make a mistake with somebody that you don't care what they think because they're close to you. If you made a mistake with your sister, who cares? You see what I'm saying? Sometimes we hold back because we're trying to make sure everything is perfect. I was talking to somebody yesterday and they said, you know what? I'm waiting till I could translate everything perfectly. I'm waiting for this. I'm waiting for that. You're going to wait until you're 6 feet under if you're waiting for things to be perfect. You want honesty? Things will never be perfect, ever. Has anything ever been perfect? And how long you been on this earth? 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 years? Okay, so we're always, see, that's an excuse. Just go out there and start doing some little things. Now, I know there's different degrees of experience on this call. If you're brand new, you know what? I tell people, just dive in, man. Let's go. If you're one of those people that want to test the water before you dive in, okay, just understand what you're doing to test the water. Maybe you're testing the water is making a list. Making is picking up the phone. Whatever it is for you. But the bottom line, guys, is we have to advertise. You got to advertise what you got. You can't be multi-level marketing secret service. Okay? It doesn't work. You're not going to get rich telling nobody that you're involved. You got to become transparent. They got to see your excitement. And that's how you get people's attention. Right? So if I made my list and I have my game plan, I got to advertise to that list. Now, what am I advertising? See, here's another thing. There's a lot of things you advertise. There's a lot of things that will capture people's attention. You want to know one of them? Okay. One of them is a new attitude. One of them is going to say, wait a minute, what the hell's going on with Lloyd? Lloyd smiled today. What's wrong with him? Man, Lloyd has a new pep in his step. I got to figure out what's going on with Lloyd. It could be his appearance. Maybe Lloyd smiled for the first time in 20 years. I'm telling you, you might laugh, but you got to show something different. If everything's the same, why am I going to ask Lloyd what's new? Well, Lloyd's just as miserable as he's always been. Okay, he's still complaining about the same old thing. So why would I ever say what's new? I know there's nothing new. But if I all of a sudden see Lloyd smiling and wearing this new thing on his device and maybe dressing differently, or maybe speaking a different type of language that I've ever heard Lloyd talk, maybe now I'm going, what's going on with you, brother? Now, does that not open up conversation? See, that's the first step. I got to get Lloyd's confidence to at least have the damn conversation. Right? So he's got to believe in what he's bought into. And I'm just using Lloyd as an example here. Okay, Lloyd, wait a minute. Now watch this. I'm going to really step on Lloyd's toes. Lloyd, I just noticed you stopped smoking. What's going on with you, brother? How you like that one, Lloyd? See? Differences. What's going on? Well, I'm making changes. I'm making some changes in my life. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. And let me tell you some of the changes I made. Conversation. That's what you got to get into, guys. You got to get into conversation. Okay, compliment, listen, attitude. Maybe how about this change? Positiveness. Is that even a word? I don't know. It is now. Okay, maybe I'm positive. Okay, maybe I'm starting to talk differently. Do you guys start to see the difference? You got to show that, whatever it is. And when you start to believe it, because you practice it, I'm telling you, it becomes contagious. It really does. But it's, and I know you guys heard me say this a lot, it's changing your hypnotic rhythm. You have a certain rhythm. Every one of you today on this call, you all have a certain rhythm that you march to every day. You know that, right? You wake up at a certain time for the most part, and you have a certain routine. Whether you want to believe it or not, your routines don't change every single day. Okay, for the most part, you have a certain hypnotic rhythm you march to. Well, that hypnotic rhythm that you've marched to for a certain amount of years has gotten you to where you are. And if you don't like where you are and you need to make changes, you got to change your hypnotic rhythm. Do you see what I'm saying? This is what I'm talking about. Watch this. When you change your hypnotic rhythm, you get people's attention because they know your rhythm. They know the conversation. They know all the things you're going to say. But when you start to change that hypnotic rhythm, right, and you change the conversation and your appearance and your lifestyle, and you start speaking differently, it get people's attention. So you got to tell people, let me ask you this. Not ask you, I'm going to tell you. You got to tell people why you're excited. Why are you excited, guys? Why are you on this call every morning? What do you want? Just go tell people that then. You can't keep it a secret. You can't keep it a secret that you want to change your financial situation, especially if you believe that you can help others change theirs. You got to write it down. You got to write it down. I know you hear this over and over and over again. You will always hold people's attention if you're really listening. See, if I know why I'm doing it, now I could be a really good investigator to find out if there's an opening. And you know how I find out? I want to find out about the person. But see, I don't have to find out about a person if I'm talking to the people I already know. I already know their hypnotic rhythm. Right? If you knew, if me and Lloyd were good buddies for years and years, we go back to high school, right? Doesn't Lloyd know me? Right? We've been through the ringer with each other. He knows what I do. He knows how many kids I have. He knows that I've been married for so long. He knows where I live. He knows the cars I drive. So he knows, he would know how to get my attention, right? Because he knows me. But if he didn't know me, he would have to ask me some questions. So you just got to understand, who are you approaching? People always say to me, okay, Jeff, I have this list. I'll go back to Brianna. I have this list. And we talked about this the other day. She goes, how am I going to approach my list? I go, well, let's grade your list. And based on what you know about that person or those people, we're going to put together the right message based on who's on your list. Because you know them. So getting people's attention, to recap this part, I got to have the right conversation. Right? I have to show a difference with my attitude, my appearance. My story's changed. What do you mean your story's changed, Jeff? Well, I've been doing what I'm doing for 14 years. I want to change my story. How about that one? I want to change my story. Because here's my story that I wanted to change. Can I tell you what my story was? Here's the story I wanted to change. I didn't want to work 12 to 14 hours every day anymore. I didn't want to put myself in a position of being paid what they thought I was worth. I didn't like the corporate downsizing. I didn't like not being at my daughter's recitals or taking them to school, okay, or being a part of their life because I was working 12, 14-hour days. I didn't like being estranged from my wife. Okay, what I meant by that is, if I'm always working, how can you have a relationship? So, yes, I want to change my story. I need to change where I was going. What part of your story do you want to change? Okay, then you got to share that with other people, because I promise you, certain people on your list have the same story. They just don't know what to do. They just think, okay, what am I going to do? And here comes all the excuses. I have no time. I can't change my story. I'm already up to my eyeballs and bills. I can't possibly do anything else. Fear comes in. But you're the fear breaker. If you're making decisions to change, it should give them enough confidence for them to at least look at what you're doing to change. This is where you become the leader, guys. You got to show that it's okay. The water's good. Come on in. Come on, everybody. The water's fine. It's not cold. You've proven that this is okay to at least look at. Is this making sense? This is how you do it. And the more you do it, the more confidence you get. And now, man, you start to hold yourself with a different posture. Now it's like, hey, man, I got this thing down. Now, eventually, you know what it's like. If you don't join my team, it'd be the dumbest decision you ever make. Eventually, that's what you got to get to, right? Because you know, people know that you know. Everybody knows that's been around Lisa and I that we know that multi-level works. They all know. Doesn't mean they're going to do it, but they least respect the industry that we're in. So I want you guys to know, you got to figure out what part of your story you want to change. And when you start to share that with other people, you watch how you get their attention. This is what I'm talking about, how to get people's attention, right here. Okay? Here's the other mistake a lot of people make. You're not in this to attack people. You're in it to attract them. You don't attack people. You attract them. You know how you attract them? I just went over. You attract them with your new attitude, with your new appearance, with your new lifestyle, with your new story. That's how you attract. A lot of you talk to people and you have dollar signs in your eyes. And you wonder why they're running the other way, because you're trying to get them. I don't try to get anybody. I just tell people why I'm excited. I have a plan. Okay, when you first get started, you have a distinct plan. You know what your plan is? Your welcome letter. That's your plan. That's your plan. That gets you organized. Within 10 minutes, you're organized. Now it's just about going out there, right, and talking to people the right way based on who's on your list. And you're going to attract them with the right message. Okay? Because I want you to understand this. Okay? The people that sell these things, do you think they have the right message? How many people today woke up and say, today's the day I'm going to find a good vacuum cleaner? You know what? Today's the day. You know what? I'm not really feeling well today. I got this cough. I think today's the day I'm going to find my cemetery lot. Who does that? Nobody. Okay? You didn't. Why would you buy some of these things? Because someone had the right message. Do you know, I've just read this, that 40% of the people in the United States pre-buy their cemetery lot? Can you imagine? That would never cross my mind. But if someone I spoke to, right, got my attention and started telling me the benefits of it, okay, otherwise I would never even think about it. Well, I got to tell you something. People don't say every day, today's the day I'm going to find a good network marketing company. Today's the day I'm going to find a good multi-level. I don't think people wake up doing that. I think people wake up and saying, I'm tired. I'm sick. I don't want to go to work. I know people wake up every day dreading Monday morning. Okay, and they look forward to Friday. I do know those things. Well, if I know those things, then I know that person is open to what? Maybe a change. So I got to know the answers to the test. And I have to know how to relay my message. Imagine selling cemetery lots, everybody. Okay, can you imagine? Okay, but you know what? It's a huge industry. All these industries that you see on here are huge industries, but people don't wake up every day thinking they need it. People don't think every day they can make a change to change their situation. So now what you got to do is you got to understand what motivates people. And I will tell you guys, with this new Facebook age out there, number one is something everybody wants. With this new social media thing, guys, I say it all the time. You talk about a narcissistic community. Okay, a narcissistic society. People want recognition. People want you to like their post. Everybody now is a director. People look for recognition. That's the number one thing people seek in an opportunity. Advancement was second, and money was third, is what people look for in opportunities. So you start to gather all this information, you then know how to press people's buttons. And when you press the right button, it opens them up more for the information you want them to receive. Follow me? This is how you start to connect. It's how you set up sometimes that 2-minute video. You got to connect first. Okay, so now if you're talking to people, their people are in different categories, right? I'll get to that in a second. But if I'm talking to somebody who has a job, what's their hot buttons? Well, lack of recognition, no advancement, poor management, bored, money last. Right? These are people why they're dissatisfied with their jobs. They're just a number. Okay? Let's say you're talking to a commission salesperson. Right? That's how they made their money their whole life. Why are they dissatisfied with their jobs? Because a lot of times, if you do a good job, they cut your commissions. Right? They play with the pay plan. Right? You make one territory number one, and then they take that territory from you and they give you a lower territory. Happens all the time in commission salespeople. They offer no future because you're as only good as your net last sale. And there's no opportunity. So if you're putting together your list, okay, how would you talk to somebody who was a commission salesperson? How would you get their attention? I'll go through that in a second. Okay. I already talked about dissatisfied with their jobs. How about if you're talking to a business owner? Okay, what do business owners face? Too much overhead. Okay, so if you're talking to a business owner and you know number one was too much overhead, how would you spin this to attract them to this type of business? Think, I'll go through that. No cash flow. Accounts receivable. Business is growing but going broke. This is a big one for a lot of businesses. No freedom. Business owns them. They just bought themselves a job. In a lot of cases. Okay, now, when you talk to a displaced executive in corporate America. I know we have a lot of those on this call. Okay, this was me. Feel used by the company. Don't like the idea of being forced out or fired. Early retirement. Mine wasn't early retirement. Mine was corporate downsizing. You understand if you work for somebody else, they're going to get theirs one way or another. They're going to either get it from increasing revenue or decreasing expenditures. The number one expense for every company is cutting payroll. That's an instant savings. Instant. People know that. So the days of working for the same company for 30, 40 years, people realize are no longer. Which means today, people are more open. Listen to my words. More open to plan B, C, D, E, and F. They know they need multiple streams of income. Okay? Now, this is how you box people. This is exactly how you box people. Right? Right? Let's say that Lloyd starts making his list. He's going to have most of his people on his list right here. They're employees. They have a job. Right? Well, what do they face? Hard work, no security, no time. Active income, touching every dollar. There'll be some people on your list, Lloyd, that are self-employed. Okay, well, if I have a self-employed person on my list, they have large debt, insufficient funds, right? They own a job. 90%, 95% of the people, 5% of the wealth. Think about this. 95% of the people are over here, but they only control 5% of the wealth. How many of you on this call have people on this side in your warm market? The business owner. They own a system. They have people working for them. Easy work, stability, spare time. They built something where they're getting a percentage off people's efforts. That's a business owner. Difference between a business owner and self-employed. Self-employed means they're there 14 hours a day. A business owner owns a system. And then how many people have people in your warm market that have it? You have investors. They've done so well in life, they have now money working for them. How many of you have those people on your list? Okay, now isn't it so funny about this? Watch this. 5% of the people in the world, but they control 95% of the wealth. This is the big tax debate you keep hearing about now, right? And I'm not saying which side, red or blue. All I'm saying is this. Okay, they keep saying you're trying to help the wealthy. You're trying to help the wealthy. You're trying to help the wealthy. 5% of the people, 95% of the wealth. Okay, so don't these people control these people? So understand, guys, you got to have the right message based on the people you're talking to. And this is what I keep talking about. It's having a strategy. And you can't have a strategy without first making your list and then boxing your people in the right category. And when I box the people in the right category, I could then tailor the message I want to send. And this is how you attract them. Right? Now, since you know your story and the things you want to change, what has the business done for you? What is it going to do for you? If it hasn't done anything yet because you're brand new, you got to tell people what it's going to do for you. That's a big difference, guys. Some people, well, I have to wait till I get results. Everybody I talk to, Jeff says, when I get results, they'll look more at it. No, baloney. Nobody bought a business and had results first, but they talked about the results they were going to get. And that's what got people. It's sharing your vision is what people are going to buy into. You got to have one, guys. You got to create a vision. You got to create what you want your white life to look like. And the reason you've created this life that you want to have is because you finally found an opportunity which will allow you to get it. That's why. You got to believe that. You got to believe that. As I wipe my nose on my own shirt, okay? So, you guys caught that? Okay. How has the business met your needs? Match what you're saying to the person. Now, how do you approach them? Based on how the fit business fits them. I just told you this because I boxed them. I put them in a box, and I know how the business is going to fit them because I know what they face. And everything they're not getting, I'm going to show how they can get it over here. I'm going to satisfy their needs because I know them. I'm going to meet their financial needs. And once I open them up, because why? Because they see a change in me. I've matched the opportunity to them. And now I know they're more open to at least receiving that 2-minute video. You guys see the difference? It's setting it up. It's not just spamming everybody. People go, how did you bring in 40 people? We set it up right. And this is how you match the opportunity. And don't roll your eyes, but if you understand this slide and really get it, this is how you match it. If I'm talking to a business owner and I'm talking about no overhead, if I'm talking about no employees, having a lifestyle with the same tax advantages, did I not just hit him between the eyes? Because what is he facing? The opposite. He's facing lots of overhead. He's facing employees. He's facing no lifestyle control. So I just took what he believes business is and I showed him there's another way. If I'm talking to somebody that's struggling day to day, right? I know without a doubt, most of the people on your list, guys, listen to me. Most of the people on your list, an extra $1,000 to $2,000 a month will change their lives. Will change their financial situation. Extra $1,000 to $2,000. Maybe the message to certain people on your list is earning money now because that's how they think. They don't think about earning money later. That's why they're in the situation they're in, because they don't think about the future because they can't. Maybe matching it to maybe cover a car payment, a mortgage payment, a child's tuition. You see the message you're sending to people? And the reason why is because you're taking advantage of the wearable tech industry. This is the vehicle. This is what's going to get them excited. Now watch this. I'm talking to an employee. You're talking to Jeff. Okay? Jeff's on your list. You've categorized Jeff as a business executive. How would you approach me? What kind of message would you want to send to me, knowing my background? Hey, Jeff. Hey, man, you know what? I just found something. So excited about it. Okay, I'm able to start it on the side. Okay, but you know what I really loved about it, Jeff? Okay, I'm going to be able to be paid what I'm worth. No glass ceiling. If you're talking to somebody that's stuck, do you think these might be two big points you might want to bring up? See, if I would have heard those things, that would attract me to what you have. Okay, if I'm talking to an employee, to a business owner, a lot of these people don't think about residual income. Do you know a big part of our income in multi-level is residual? There's a certain age group that's attracted to residual. And I never want to say everybody, but I'm saying for the most part, someone's got to be in the workforce 10, 15 years before they start thinking about residual. Because they're enamored in what they do if they're brand new in it, right? But a certain time in your life, you go, wait a minute, how long am I going to keep doing this? And if I really want residual income, do you know a lot of people don't even know what it is? It's doing the work once and getting paid for that work into the future. That's residual. That's where time freedom comes in, money freedom, not trading time for dollars. Okay? And then you sum it up. These are just all the things that our opportunity offers is by being part of our system. If I'm talking to somebody really busy, and most of your people are going to say, I have no time, that's going to be the number one thing you're going to have to overcome. In my opinion, it's the number one thing that stalls people. It's an easy thing to say, I have no time. So that stops you in your tracks. Well, hang on a second. You got to overcome that before it even comes up. What I love about this is I haven't quit my day job. And the reason I'm able to do this, because I have no time, is I'm leveraging the system they have in place. Doesn't require my time. Doesn't require a lot of my time. You see how you do that? So anticipate what they're going to say. And overcome it through your own story. Man, the other thing I'm really getting out of this, guys, is personal development. Man, coaching every morning. Systems. Company has different types of system. Turnkey programs that are exciting. Weekly calendar of events, mostly online. I don't have to go to people's living rooms or hotel meetings. Most of the stuff we're doing is online. Through social media. So guys, if you start to understand this slide, you can match this to whoever is on your list. You just got to be aware. You got to have an awareness about you. You got to have a strategy. You got to have a plan. And I just walked you through the plan and the strategy. Make your list, categorize your people, and based on what you know about them, what message do you want to send? Based on what you know they're facing. And just start with a conversation. Some of the conversations that we tell people to do in the beginning are very straightforward. And that's what we want you to do. You're starting a company. You're putting together your board of directors. Right? You're positioning your team within this new wearable tech industry. I want to send you this 2-minute video, and I want you to watch it with the thought process of earning a percentage off every device sold. But before you even get to that, you're letting them know, right, all the different and why you made the change. And why you made the change is exactly what you know about them on why they would want to make the change. It's how you spin your story based on who you're talking to. And guys, if this is overwhelming, this is why you need to practice. See, to me, it's just like, rolls off my tongue. I've been doing it 25 damn years. Of course it rolls off my tongue. People go, I want to be like you. 25 years. It's practicing. I'm not suggesting it's going to take you that long, but you got to start. And you can't care. You can't care what other people think. So that's, hang on. Do I want to save? Yeah, I guess I do. All right, save. But let me go off. Hang on. Hi. I'm done. I'm done. I'm hungry. All right. So what time is it? Oh, wow. An hour. I can't believe how hour just goes boom. All right. So tonight, guys, 6 o'clock. Share the heck out of that. Let's put together a plan, all of us, to have a guest on the call tonight. One guest on the call. And watch what happens. Go practice. Organize yourself. Put your people in the category. And let's put together the plan to start reaching out. Thank you, guys. Talk to you soon. Hey, bye.